Everyone, so I'm Josh Halpern. I'm a reproductive urologist and sexual health specialist at Northwestern Medicine. And we're talking today about an interesting case, and this is a patient that we saw a few months back that I thought would be a really interesting case to present as far as fertility goes. And so this was a 32-year-old man who came to see us with a history of VACTERL, so you know, that syndrome where you can have vertebral anomalies and anal atresia, a number of other congenital anomalies. And he had undergone a number of surgeries when he was a child for this, but really didn't have a great recollection or any great records of what those looked like. He was living a totally normal life, very healthy guy, but by the time he came to see us, he had been trying to conceive with his partner, who was also 32 years old, for almost a year. And that had led them to get some initial evaluation, and semen analysis sure enough showed that this patient had azoospermia. He had very low volume azoospermia, so no sperm in the ejaculate, with about 0.1, 0.2 cc's on his two specimens. And so by the time he came to see me, we got some blood work, which had shown that he had a normal testosterone and FSH, all consistent with an obstructive azoospermia pattern. And by the time I saw him, a good physical exam did reveal that he actually had an absent vas deferens on the left side, absent part of his left epididymis. And on the right side, he did have a normal epididymis, but there was a little bit of dilation and the vas deferens was present. So again, all of this kind of looking like an obstructive picture, especially since he also had normal labs and his testicles were normal with normal volume. So, you know, given the fact that he had this hint of obstruction and his VACTERL history, I sent him for a couple additional tests. First, I sent him for genetic testing in the absence of the vas deferens, looking for a CFTR mutation, which indeed he ended up having. We also sent him for an MRI of his prostate and seminal vesicles to look for some sort of cause of obstruction, not just on his left side, but also on his right side. And sure enough, you can see behind me on the MRI, they found a large cyst, which seemed to be emanating either from the seminal vesicle or from the ejaculatory duct. And so we had a nice conversation about kind of the options there. Certainly there was an option to try some sort of transurethral resection to open up that right-sided obstruction. The concern was that given all the history that he had, all the surgeries he had, perineally and otherwise as a child, that we might put him at risk and we might not succeed. And so the patient instead opted for a sperm extraction procedure. Sure enough, we took him to the operating room, we did a Mesa and a Tessie, so we got sperm from the testicle and the epididymis. We got great sperm. His testicles clearly were producing sperm with normal spermatogenesis. We froze about 10 vials of sperm, and just in the last few weeks or so, we found out that this couple is now pregnant through IVF. So really interesting case, not a lot out there as far as VACTERL and fertility on the male side of things. Whether this was the CFTR component or the VACTERL, probably don't know, but really great case and great outcome for the patient.